Just before we start, a quick shout out to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. This is not a photo of a Milky Way or an artist's impression. This is a map made up of approximately 1.8 billion data points collected by the Gaia satellite. Each one not just representing a star, but also comets, asteroids, and other astronomical objects in the Milky Way and beyond. But it's not just taking images of the night sky, it's also measuring the speed, direction of travel, and color of each star to build up a 3D space catalog of the Milky Way, not only up to 30,000 light years in all directions from Earth, but also other more distant objects like galaxies and quasars are also being mapped. With this data and applying the laws of celestial mechanics, we can run time backwards and forwards to see how the Milky Way formed and how it and our little part of it will move and interact with the rest of the nearby stars for millions of years into the future. So how does one small satellite orbiting the Sun along with the Earth build up such a huge amount of data to let us see things on a grand scale that we've never seen before? The Gaia Space Observatory was launched by the European Space Agency in 2013, and its primary role is to map the visible section of the Milky Way and other celestial objects using astrometry. Astrometry precisely measures the position, movement, and brightness of stars, comets, asteroids, and other celestial bodies. It's fundamental for fields like celestial mechanics, stellar dynamics, and galactic astronomy, and can be dated back to the ancient Greeks. The problem with stars and other celestial objects is that working out their distance from Earth can be difficult. A star could be very bright, but very far away, whereas a dimmer star could be much closer. Yet, they could both look very similar to an Earth-based observer. However, there is a way to work out the distance using parallax, similar to our own stereoscopic vision. We have two eyes, which see the same image from slightly different positions, and our brains use this difference to calculate the distance to an object. To do that, we need to have eyes, or the camera equivalent, tens of millions of kilometers apart. Astrometry takes advantage of the fact that the Earth is 148 million kilometers from the Sun and rotates around it once per year. So for example, in December, the Earth will be on one side of the Sun, and in June it will be on the other side, and the combined distance between these two points is 298 million kilometers. If an astronomer takes two images of the same star, one in December and one in June, the results will show the star has moved relative to the background stars. And by doing some trigonometry, we can work out the distance to the star. This is how Gaia works, but instead of taking just two images, it takes a continuous stream of them. This way, it can scan 2 million stars an hour as it orbits around the Sun, and then select which stars it's going to track and analyze. Each star's position is recorded relative to its background, the color, brightness, and spectral shift. The spectral shift shows if it's moving towards us or away from us. As Gaia moves along its orbit, it takes new images of the same star, and using this data, the distance to each can be calculated as well as its direction of travel. Over its original operational lifetime, Gaia was expected to scan each star over 70 times to build up a 3D model of how each star moves relative to us and all the other stars. This allows us to see where they were in the past and where they will be in the future, something we've never been able to see accurately before. Gaia actually orbits at the Lagrange point L2, approximately 1.5 million kilometers from Earth. Here, it orbits around the Earth as the Earth orbits around the Sun. This way, it can scan the space outwards from the Sun and maintain a direct line of sight with the Earth with which to send the data back to. Gaia uses two main telescopes that look out from the main satellite body, separated by 160 degrees. The light from these two are focused through a series of mirrors onto the largest sensor array so far put into space. Many of the stars it sees are much fainter than can be seen by the human eye, some up to 400,000 times fainter. The array is made up of 106 separate CCD devices, each having 4,500 by 1966 pixels, with a combined pixel count of 937.8 megapixels and covering almost half a square meter in size. As each of the elements in the CCDs are much larger than normal, it is also about 100 times more sensitive than a normal camera CCD. The mirrors are mounted onto a frame made from silicon carbide, a very thermally stable material that is as hard as diamond and provides a highly stable mounting basis for the optical system, along with the 10-meter diameter sun shield to protect the optics and sensors and thermally stable Lagrange point in space, the accuracy of the measurements Gaia can make is incredible. The angular level of precision is 10 micro arc seconds, which is an angle equivalent to the width of a 23 millimeter diameter coin on the surface of the moon measured from the Earth. To enable the repeatability of this extreme precision, Gaia uses 8 micro thrusters, which produce just 1 micro newton of pressure, about 1 million times less than a typical thruster. Gaia has no moving parts like reaction wheels or gyroscopes, other than actuators to align the mirrors and valves for the thrusters. As Gaia rotates, it looks at 2 patches of space simultaneously. These are separated by 108 degrees, and the light from the stars travel across the sensors as Gaia turns, providing a continuous moving image strip of the space that the telescopes see. The light is folded and reflected by the mirrors onto the sensors, which are split into several parts that do different jobs to analyse the images it captures. The sensors on the right of this image determine the stars that are to be tracked. As the image travels across the main astrometric field sensor, the 9 strips of CCDs analyse the selected stars for their brightness and position. To cut down on the huge amount of data this generates, only a small window around each star is recorded as it traverses the sensor. To the immediate left of these are 2 photometers, which receive light via a couple of special prisms that detect the star's colour, size and chemical composition before the image ends by traversing the radial velocity spectrometer. This detects the amount of red or blue shift in the light from the star or object to determine if it's travelling towards us or away from us and how fast. All this is repeated for each star as Gaia turns on its axis every 6 hours. All the data is then compressed and stored before being sent back to ESA at 1 megabit per second, the equivalent of 50 gigabytes of data per day. After 5 years of operation, some 60 terabytes of compressed data has been sent, equating to 200 terabytes of uncompressed data to analyse back on Earth. All of this tells us a lot about the evolution of the Milky Way and how we came to be where we are in it. It has shown that stars which are born within the stellar nurseries within the Milky Way tend to stay together and rotate around the galactic plane together. But there are other groups of stars which move in very different ways, indicating that they were captured from other smaller galaxies which have collided with the Milky Way over time. It also shows our galaxy's disk is warped and that it processes or wobbles on its axis like a buckled wheel rather than being on a flat plane. Again, something which would have been affected by interactions with other galaxies in the past. These collisions trigger new star formation as new gas is introduced from external sources and areas with higher gas densities create new stars. One of these collisions is believed to have occurred about 6 billion years ago and led to a wave of new star formation, including our Sun, solar system, and ultimately the Earth and us. Such is the precision of the measurement that we can also track stars in the Milky Way's satellite galaxies, the Large and Small Magellanic Clouds. We can also see into the Andromeda galaxy, some 2 million light years away, which is on a collision course with the Milky Way, but not for another 4 billion years or so. It can also track asteroids, over 14,000 so far, and as time goes by, more are added to the catalogue. As Gaia scans the whole sky and not just the plane of the asteroid belt, it has found new ones, which orbit at a much higher angle, indicating they are not native to the solar system and were flying by when they were captured by the sun's gravity. All of this is providing us with an amazing insight into how our galaxy formed and will continue to evolve for millions of years into the future, something that no other single satellite has been able to do with such great precision so far. Gaia is a triumph of data gathering, capturing millions of data points to inform us of what has happened in the past and what will happen in the future. To run a successful business online, blog, or online presence, gathering data on how well your website performs is just as important. With Squarespace, you get not only great web hosting and tools to help you manage it, Squarespace will also give you a great-looking website to grow your business or online presence. Using their powerful included blogging tools, you can create and grow a community where you can categorize, schedule, and share posts and build interaction with their fully integrated commenting system. You can connect with your audience and generate revenue through gated, members-only content. Manage your members, send email communications, and connect with your social media accounts to push your website content to them and spread the word via your followers, all in one easy-to-use platform. If you're looking for an online store, they have new third-party tools to manage inventory, promote products, track sales, and handle tax and shipping worldwide. All you need to do to get started is to go to squarespace.com for a free trial. Then, when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/curiousdroid to save 10% off of your first purchase of a website or domain.